Dr. Patnaik, respected CMD, Dr. Iran, and friends. Today, I am going to present before you a rare case of abdominal wall tumor. She is a young lady of 23 years from our colony itself, and she got admitted on 29 of October 2013 with complaint of recurrent pain left upper abdomen for the duration of 1.5 months. There is no history of trauma or fever. There is no vomiting, jaundice, hematemesis or melena. There is no urinary problems and bowel habits are normal. There is no history of bleeding for rectum. Abdominal examination revealed 5.5 cm thumb, tender long, palpable at left upper abdominal wall over the rectus muscle. There is no localized of temperature, skin was free from the tumor, and leg raising test reduces the size of the swelling. General examination revealed no abnormality. And internal examination of the abdomen revealed liver spleen not palpable. There is no other lump in the abdomen, there is no ascites. Bowel sounds are normally hard, colorectal examination normal, and spine was normal. Little bit of past history, during her first visit to hospital for a similar complaint, that is pain over the left hypochondrium, on 14th of August 2013, clinical examination was normal, there was no clinical finding, but she was complaining of pain over the left hypochondrium, it was severe in nature. So, keeping the all possibilities, I did endoscopy of the abdomen to a student in gastric pathology on 16th of August, which is normal. Ultrasound was advised that was also of abdomen was advised that was also normal on 19th of August, it was done. And to exclude renal pathology and renal stone, X-ray KUK was also done. It was also normal because her elder sister had presented about 1 year back pain right in her fossa and with features of acute appendicitis. When I opened, the appendix was normal, there was a lump in the cecum. And we excised that lump, that is cecum and ascending colon, and biopsy was angiodysplasia. So keeping that in mind, because of family history of angiodysplasia, I did stool occult, which is also negative, and I proposed colonoscopy. But she refused because the pain subsided about 7 or 10 days of initial examination. It has X-ray QOP, which is normal. Ultrasound abdomen, liver, IHR, non-directed liver is normal. There is no swell, gallbladder, pancreas, kidneys, and uterine adnexa, etc. were normal. So, blood parameters are all within normal limits. So the extra chest, that's also normal. So because of that lump, 5 cm, 5 cm lump on the left rectus muscle, I did a CT scan of the abdomen on 11th of October. It shows liver as normal, IHBR not directed, gallbladder normal. Spleen, adrenal, kidneys are normal, uterus are just bulky, ovaries are normal, retroperitoneum normal, there is no free fluid, and gut was normal. But there was a well-defined hyperdense lesion about 25 into 22 millimeter was seen in the left rectus muscle, just inferior to the level of the lower pole of the kidneys. Impression was rectus with hematoma on the left side. Because CT scan gave impression of hematoma, but there was no history of fever. So I gave her some analgesics and anti-inflammatory drugs, but it did not subside. So I subjected her for tetanus. This is the CT scan finding. This is the mass. on the rectus muscle. The same thing. So epiphyse shows smears are highly cellular and so discrete round cells having moderate nuclear biomorphism, inconspicuous nucleoli and scanty cytoplasm. Mitotic activity was seen. Features are suggestive of malignant small round cell tumor. So pathologists are advised for doing excision of the tumor and histopathological intervention with immunohistochemistry to confirm the type of the tumor. Subsequently, we also did MRI of abdomen to see the origin and extent of the tumor and any other pathology in the abdomen. But everything was normal excepting this is finding abdominal skeleton and soft tissues, a well-defined enhancing lesion, 3.5 into 2.8 into 4.1 cm, seen in the rectus muscle. The visualized abdominal skeleton and soft tissues appear otherwise in one microscope. Impression was encapsulated lesion in the left rectus muscle, likely to be due to desmoid tumor. So desmoid tumor is, as you know, it is a benign condition, but it's usually recurs. So for which wide excision of the tumor is indicated. This is the MRI finding. This was the mass. So with repeat blood parameters before operation, which were within normal limits. So we planned for operation with a wide excision under the general anesthesia and because the wide gap would be wide, so we planned for a mass repair of the defect and subject for histopathology and immunohistochemistry examination of the tumor. So a transverse incision was given over the tumor. Excision of the mass with 1.5 cm healthy margin was done from rectus seat till the peritoneum, that means almost whole wall of the abdomen, including taking the subcutaneous tissue along with it, subcutaneous fat along with it.
So open all
through
the laparoscopic?
No. It is a wall. Abdominal wall view. So this is the tumor being excised with wide margin.
Biopsy report, what happened?
Round cell tumor, malignant round cell tumor. The FNS report was there. Biopsy after excise, we set for histopathology. So this is the whole tumor and whole abdominal wall was taken. This is the defect after excision of the tumor. Whole, everything was whole wall. This is another view. So while operating Dr. Malhotra and myself, so we are wondering what could be the nature of the tumor which came after histopathology. So closure of defect, the gap was repaired with inlay 15 into 15 cm tissue separating mesh from within and fixed with zero proline. This is the mesh because this is a composite mesh. It has got two layers. This is dual facing mesh made of polyester and absorbable hydrophilic film. It remains to the visceral side, so it prevents adhesion to the abdominal organs. Otherwise, this ordinary proline, if you give, then there will be adhesions and subsequent complications. This is a Paritex composite mesh. This is the inlay mesh being deployed. This is 15 cm mesh. This is the exterior view. Inside there are the hydrophilic film was there. So it was fixed with the abdominal wall with proline surrounding the defect. For giving better strength, because she was a young lady, she have subsequent pregnancies, etc. So another layer of 15 cm only ultra-pro mesh was also applied. This is the another layer of ultra-pro. It was also fixed to the. And this is the specimen. This is the peritoneal side. This is the outer side. It's the subcutaneous fat was taken to safeguard prevent recurrence. And this is the tumor. Another view of the same tumor. and scheme was closed with subcutaneous monopil with a vacuum drain. Post-operative period was uneventful, excepting a small seroma which disappeared with further treatment. This is the scar after 3 months of operation. This is a recent photograph of the gallery. These are the incision given. Dr. Sadhu was asking, this is the abdominal wall. This is the incision that is given.
This is a horizontal incision?
Yes.
Because it was.
This is again an incision for this.
Generally, after some power material.
So coming to histopathology, it has an overall mass of 7 into 4 into 3 cm. It shows well circumcised tumor of 2.5 2.7 cm.